Everyone cares about food. It's just a massive market.
In 2019, over 650,000 food and beverage establishments spanned the U.S., growing at more than double the rate of the population over the last decade. But this growth has spurred investors' interest in food tech companies that are changing the face of that industry through automation.
One of the things that we've always seen with restaurants, it's a high fixed cost business. If you look at like opening a restaurant, it costs hundreds of thousands of dollars. You're stuck in one place and you're only serving really a couple block radius. We're moving towards a world where we don't necessarily have to have fixed in place high cost infrastructure. You can basically spin up a new food concept by basically using cloud kitchens, by accessing other people's infrastructure through cloud kitchen as a service, by leveraging and riding on the backs of things like Grubhub and other infrastructure plays. And then you start to talk about the idea of food robots.
In addition to cloud kitchens, which are stripped down commercial operations with no dine-in option, companies like Spice and Creator are working on ways to automate aspects of traditional restaurant dining.
It's really starting from what's a really interesting problem to solve and what's a real market need.
A startup in Seattle called Picnic has built a pizza robot that it positions as a cost-effective way for restaurants to create consistent pies. The Picnic robot automates pizza assembly via a form of artificial intelligence called deep learning. It can assemble 300 oven-ready pizzas per hour.
We see the problem in industry, the pain point of an inconsistent product and food waste. If you look at most of the automation solutions around pizza, what we're doing is something nobody else is doing, which is actually applying the ingredients to the pizza. There's so much energy and there's so much innovation happening. And when we look at specifically the food preparation automation space, there's solutions for every kind of food, whether it's coffee or smoothies or pizza or salad, and it's a fun place to be.
There's just a lot of different really interesting combinations that we're gonna see that'll, I think, completely reshape the restaurant business over the next 10 years.